Welcome back, everybody. We have CJ Pham with us. What song are you going to do today?
Waiting for the Moon.
Take it away.
I've been waiting all morning for the sun to rise, hey. And I tell you, I've been waiting far too long.
Goodness gracious. That was unbelievable.
Thank you.
I'm like almost speechless. I'm standing over here listening to it with my buddy Noah here, and we were both about to cry. I'm not even joking you.
Good. That's good. The song is supposed to be a tearjerker.
You're so soulful. Were you like singing the choir as a kid or in chorus or something?
Chorus. Yeah, no. Other than that, no.
No? Mm-mm. I wonder where the soulful influence comes from. Is it that just you?
I mean, honestly, it was from like the music I listened to. I listened to a lot of Amy Winehouse, like as a kid. That was my artist. Like her, Aretha Franklin, Christina Aguilera. Like those were the artists that I would listen to. And I was like, man, I want to be like them one day. I'm going to be them one day.
Better than them.
Oh my gosh.
You can't say that.
I can't say that. They're my idols. I can't say that.
So you're going to college right now. You live in Tennessee, right?
I do, Nashville, Tennessee. I'm going to Belmont University for songwriting. And it's pretty cool. It's the top songwriting school in the country.
Whoa.
So it's absolutely incredible. The experience has been insane. I love Nashville. Yeah.
Yeah. What is it that you like so much about Nashville?
I gotta say, it's just like everyone there is so in love with music. Like they eat, sleep, and breathe it. You know, because here in South Florida, you have like the little cliques of people who, you know, you have like your small group of musicians. But out there, everyone there is music. You can talk to anyone on the street and have a full-blown conversation about music. It's incredible. Yeah.
So that just naturally would make people more interested in music.
Yeah, yeah. Naturally, you just start a conversation and all of a sudden, like, I'm a songwriter and I would talk to other songwriters and then you start collabing and then wow. It's like, it's this whole connection. It's networking. It's like, it's the home of networking for music.
So that makes sense why I've had a bunch of other musicians tell me that that's the place to be.
Yeah, Nashville is like the new upcoming, I mean, it's always been Music City. It's been called Music City, but it really is for like the younger generation. That's the place to be for music right now.
That's so awesome. Yeah. And you're going to the number one school. That's even cooler. So you're from here. So what are you off school right now? And what are you up to right now?
Yeah, I'm here for summer. I've been having a bunch of gigs. I perform like 4 times a week. Honestly, I've just been writing more. I've been getting in the studio because I just released my album, my debut album that just came out. It's called Unbroken Heart. It's all one word. Trying to be artistic.
Yep.
And so over the summer, I started working with more writers and I'm getting in the studio for my next project because a singer never stops, you know?
Yes.
It's more content.
It's like it's in you and it just has to come out.
Yeah, honestly. And especially since, you know, I'm writing a lot of the music that's on there
right. Is,
you know, these are like my stories. It's my way of getting out what I want to say. So
I feel it. I like it so much. I just can't believe how flawless your voice was and the control that you had. And as well as the songwriting, you wrote that song about what?
Literally, it was about the moon. Sounds so cliche, but I was sitting at my piano at home and I was like, man, I haven't written anything in a while. Like, I need to get out of my writer's block. And literally, I looked outside. I saw the moon. It was really pretty. It was like one of those full moons.
Yep.
And I was like, you know what? That's it. And I just started playing some random chords and whatever came to my head, I ended up writing that song in 6 minutes.
Say what?
Yeah, 6 minutes is pretty crazy.
So you broke the block, the writer's block.
I did. And then all of a sudden, like, the rest of the album started like writing itself as
yes.
I was like, it was great. It was one of those like very.
Yeah, the creative juices were flowing.
Oh yeah, it didn't stop. I was like up till like 5 a.m.
That's what they say. They say that the late night hours are the best time.
Yeah, because that's, you know, like you're like the most relaxed, like, you know, there's like nothing really else to do. And
no distractions.
And no distractions. And it's just music and it just like comes out
yeah.
of you. It's crazy.
Wow. You're crazy.
Yes, I've been told that before. I've been told that was crazy.
So where can we find more of your music?
So you guys can find me on social media. Everything is literally CJ Fam. Fam is like family without the I-O-Y.
Right.
You can check out my website, cjfam.com. That has links to my album, all my performances, where you can find me next. My music, you can find it anywhere. On online, YouTube, iTunes, Spotify, Amazon, Google, wherever. It's everywhere. So
that's pretty easy. CJ Fam.
Yeah, you know, Fam is actually my actual last name.
People is it really?
Yeah, it is my legal last name.
Wow.
Yeah.
Well, that makes it easy to search.
Exactly, yeah.
So no one has an excuse to not find you.
Exactly.
Yes.
You hear that, guys? No excuses. No excuses. Look me up. No, just kidding.
Thank you so much for being here.
Thank you so much for having me. It's been incredibly fun. I love it here.
Yes. Thank you guys for watching. And stay tuned every week for more great artists. Take care. Don't try to save the day.